It's Tuesday, November 23rd, 2010. I'm Kevin McShan, and this is the McShan Sports Beat Report.
Fans have received an early Christmas present. Minnesota fired coach Brad Childress a day after a humiliating loss to NFC North rival Green Bay. After playing in the conference title game last season, the Vikings were expected to be a strong contender this season as well. But it's been a season filled with controversy and disappointment. First, there's the Brett Favre drama. The veteran quarterback spent another offseason hemming and hawing about retirement until three Vikings players went to his home late in training camp and talked him into playing. Then there was the quarterback controversy when Favre was injured and in danger of ending his Iron Man streak of consecutive starts. Childress also brought in Randy Moss, trading a third-round draft pick to New England for the veteran receiver, only to cut him less than a month later. Sunday's 31-3 loss to the Packers dropped the Vikings to 3-7 and apparently was the last straw for owner Ziggy Wilf. It was the most lopsided home defeat in Childress' 5 years in charge of the Vikings. He leaves after compiling an overall record of 40-37, including a 1-2 mark in the playoffs. Defensive coordinator Leslie Frazier will serve as interim head coach for the remainder of the season. Jim Bell, the Associated Press.
A wise man once said, a house divided cannot stand. And for the Minnesota Vikings, the foundation of their house has been crumbling all season long. And on Monday, we reached the climax of this horror film when head coach Brad Childress received his walking papers and was relieved of his duties as head coach. Childress received the axe on Monday. One season after, he guided the Vikings to a record of 12-4, received a contract extension, and came within a field goal of punching a ticket to Super Bowl 44. Not to mention his famous car ride to the airport to retrieve Brett Favre in a last-ditch attempt to capture that ever-so-elusive championship. Vikings owner Ziggy Wilf was complimentary in his comments regarding Childress. He thanked him for his service to the organization and turning around the franchise. Wilf says, it's difficult to put into words why change is needed. He was an integral part of helping this franchise turn the corner and reestablishing ourselves as a force in the NFL, as well as bringing in players who did an excellent job of representing themselves and our organization in this community. It's often difficult to articulate one reason why change is needed, Wilf said. ESPN's Ed Werder attempts to read between the lines as to why Wilf pulled the plug on Childress. He also provides some perspective on how the environment inside the Vikings locker room had deteriorated over the last several weeks, and how support for Childress had waned.
Ed Werder joins us now from the Vikings facility in Eden Prairie, Minnesota. And Ed, what can you tell us more about the firing of Brad Childress today?
Well, it's clear that Ziggy Wilf has finally reached the point where it became obvious to him yesterday that Brad Childress is no longer supported by his players, that he is no longer able to motivate them to play in games. There were allegations in the locker room after the loss to Green Bay yesterday that the players accused one another of quitting on each other and quitting on their season. They had lost the last two games to the top two teams in their own division, a division they've won the last 2 years, by a total score of 58-16. Brett Favre at the end of the game saying the score would indicate players had quit. And even before this, a couple of weeks ago, players telling me, we're tired of his BS, he needs to go. And as late as last night, talking to players after the game about what they thought Favre was doing when he was reevaluating whether he was committed to remaining the starting quarterback, they said they didn't know because they didn't even know who would make that decision in this organization.
Then who will make that decision going forward now? This team has been about the coach, and it's been about the quarterback. So what about Favre and that reevaluation quote and what they do going forward?
Well, I can tell you with absolute certainty that Brett Favre did not have a good relationship with his head coach, and that became obvious when I talked to him on Friday going into this Green Bay game, and the thing he said that resounded with him from the previous Green Bay game, the one in Lambeau Field, and all likelihood his last game at Lambeau Field, was not that he finished the game playing with two broken bones in his foot or that the Green Bay crowd was so hostile toward him. It was that he went to his press conference after the game having been warned that Childress had criticized the quarterback and had said it publicly that he had thought about benching him during the game at Lambeau Field. Favre was incensed about that even a month later. So that gives you some idea about the depth of the division on this team between the head coach and the quarterback. As far as Favre's decision, still no word on that. I've tried to reach him multiple times. It's an odd thing for a quarterback to be saying he's reevaluating with six games left his commitment to remaining the starting quarterback. And when Favre was asked yesterday at his press conference after the game if he would consider retiring prematurely, he didn't rule it out. So I think this move will, in all likelihood, bring Favre back or cause him to remain. And perhaps everybody will play with a little more inspiration in the following six games, all of which appear to be meaningless otherwise at this point.
So again, just to clarify, you think Favre will last the year in Minnesota?
Well, I just think that his, you know, legacy is not only winning one Super Bowl and playing in two and accumulating statistics that make him the greatest quarterback in the history of the game based on numbers, but he's told me, I'm the ultimate competitor. I may not throw the best ball. I may not be the best quarterback, but I think the thing you'll say about me is I'm the ultimate competitor. So I don't see, given all that, how he can quit with six games left or, you know, even find a politically correct way to give up the job. I think unless the coaches want to bench him, I think he's got to stay and play or else his critics will see it that way.
I am proud of our accomplishments, and I believe the foundation of the football team is stronger today than the day I became head coach, Childress said in a statement released by the team. Defensive coordinator Leslie Frazier talks about the challenges he faces in his new role as interim head coach as he attempts to lead the Vikings for the final six games of 2010.
Thank you, Ziggy. I'd like to thank the entire Wilf family for entrusting me with this role of leadership here with the Minnesota Vikings. They've been very good to me and my entire family during our time here. I'd also like to thank Brad Childress, who not only a very good friend, but a mentor in so many ways, and primarily responsible for my being in Minnesota. I'll always be grateful for Brad for the time that we spent together, and I wish him nothing but the best. Had a chance to speak to our team earlier, really trying to challenge our guys as we look forward to this next ball game, as we prepare for the Washington Redskins, just stressing to them the importance of looking forward and not looking back. You know, there will be a lot of things written about the past, but the one thing I'm hoping that all of our players recognize is that we can only do what we can do going forward. And that means our focus and our attention has to be on the Washington Redskins, period. Anything else is really inconsequential to what we have to achieve as a group. And that's the one thing I tried to get across to our players. And hopefully when we come back on Wednesday, all of our focus, all of our energy will be on the Washington Redskins, period. If that's the case, we'll achieve the things that we should achieve over the course of this, the remainder of this football season. So with that, I'll open it up for questions. The one thing I tried to address with our guys today was, I mean, you want to be a good teammate. That's part of being successful in our league. And, you know, we're going to address a number of different things in the days and weeks to come, but being a good teammate is paramount to having a successful football team. And if everybody buys into that and just understand the importance of encouraging one another when you're going through tough times, because sometimes adversity can bring out, you know, who you actually are. And we're going through an adverse time. But this is a day, in some ways, a day of celebration for our team, because it's a chance for us to really embrace this opportunity that we have as a group to focus our energy on the Washington Redskins and not get caught up in anything other than that. And that's where we're headed. You know, to be honest, Mike, I'm really not. I'm really more concerned about making sure that our guys are focused on what they got to get done. We come back on Wednesday and then practice on Thursday and Friday, and we travel on Saturday. That's the most important thing to me right now. Anything other than that is really not on the radar.
Paul Allen, the voice of the Vikings, shares his initial reaction once he learned the news that Childress had been fired.
I guess the proper way to put it is we can look at the way yesterday's game developed. And as I've said all along the way, when people were all over this for years and weeks leading up to this, you know, I always said that when you have a game like you had yesterday, that's when the red flags are all over the place. And we had one, and Brad Childress got fired because of it.
Yep.
And it's not just because of that. There are many directions you can go here. I guess for those of you who have wanted this for as long as you have, I guess it's your opportunity to call and celebrate over somebody losing a job. I never do that. No matter if it's 31-3, if it's 12 men in the huddle, if it's Mike Tice at the end of a Love Boat year, I don't do that. It's steely, it's businesslike, and it's time to move on. Leslie Frazier will become the interim coach, according to Jay Glazer, and we will see what type of decisions and what type of spark or jump or motivation they get from this team the rest of the way with Leslie Frazier as the interim coach. It also gives Leslie Frazier an opportunity to win the head coaching job for the Minnesota Vikings next year. Just like Jason Garrett has the opportunity to win that with the Dallas Cowboys, Leslie Frazier has an opportunity to win that job. Some will say, why did it take so long for this to happen in a season that some felt was rudderless before others felt it was? I don't have a problem with the timing of it, and I stay consistent with things that I have said over the course of the season. There, from the amount of turnovers to the lack of execution to the way certain games were developing, where you legitimately had a chance to win, I did not make coaching the number one reason that this team was where it was. The thing is that there just weren't a lot of telltale things for me to say that man is the reason this is happening. And after yesterday's game, the bludgeoning, it's unfair to completely say that man's the reason this happened. But like I've said, this show and over the last several weeks,
yeah,
he contractually has more power than any coach since Denny Green. And it's his responsibility to run a distraction-free locker room and win more than he loses. And neither has taken place this year.
During times of adversity, we all have to look deep inside of our souls and search for the answers that escape us. For the Minnesota Vikings, they've been searching for answers all season long to no avail. There are a number of reasons why Brad Childress lost his job, many of which you've heard in this report. But now, for the players, the shadow of convenience is gone, with Childress receiving his walking papers on Monday. Now, it's time for the Minnesota Vikings to man up and start playing inspired football. That task falls on the shoulders of interim head coach Leslie Frazier, who has a chance to secure this job for the long term. But as we've seen all season long, that mandate for the Vikings hasn't been easy to follow. So we'll see if a fresh face and a new voice makes any bit of difference moving forward as they prepare for the Redskins and for the remainder of the season. Kevin McShann, McShann Sports Beat, reports.